Welcome back to the Atari ST Nostalgia GFA Basic Tour. In the previous video, we looked at the built-in get and put and sget and sput commands for putting graphics on screen much faster than the drawing commands ever could. And in this video, I want to explore how we can use these default commands to get our graphics moving across the screen or on the screen. Now, before we start, I would just like to add a little disclaimer. This video will contain some smooth movements, but the standard monochrome mode is actually running at 71 Hz, and I'm using an emulator set at 60 Hz on my 60 Hz screen and syncing those two with each other and also capturing at 60 frames per second, which means you might see the occasional motion judder. Now, this is because of my emulator and capture settings, not with GFA Basic or the ST, because on a real ST, the judder will not be there. But having said that, let's go into the editor and start comparing drawing to putting again. Because I've created a little bit of code in where I will I will make a ball by drawing a circle, putting an Atari logo in it, and then getting it with the get command. And I will compare drawing the ball, which basically from left to right, I'm going to draw a p-circle with a 24 pixel radius. And after I've drawn it, I'm going to clear the screen and then draw the next one. And if I don't clear the screen, it will just become a big line. But if you use drawing commands, these are probably the only options you have to sort of make an animation. And this is also the way they explain it into like very, very basic instruction books for GFA Basic. But I don't think it's very acceptable. But I wanted to show you just in case. And the other one is I'm going to actually also do the coordinates from left to right, but I'm going to use the put command to put the ball in screen just to see how much difference it actually makes. So let's run this program. And as you can see, it's drawing the ball. It's very flickery. It's in steps of 10 pixels and it doesn't look like an animation. It's just way too slow and flickery. So this is just totally unacceptable for any form of animation. I don't think this is a good idea. But the put command, you can see, it's actually way faster. I mean, remember, I'm shifting the circle by 10 pixels at a time. This one shifts by 1 pixel every step, and it's still faster across the screen. So the put command really is a lot faster than drawing command. And what we also can see, however, is a little problem we still have. Because we can see some line going from top to bottom through this circle, and it's causing some deformities. And the reason for that is the put command is so fast that it's going faster than the screen gets updated in this case. So the vertical blank, you can actually see the vertical blank moving through the object. So what we have to do if you want really smooth animations is actually make it more smooth by using a vsync command. And what the vsync command does, it waits for the next vertical blank. So basically when the screen starts building up from the top, so when the electron beam is at the top on a CRT monitor, and then it executes the command. So you won't have this out of sync flickering. And I should actually remove the circle because no one wants to see this ever again. This is just a very feeble attempt and not working. So I will remove that for next time. But you can see actually the putting of the circle is now super, super smooth without any flicker. So that's pretty cool. And I'm drawing the circle directly on screen, which also means when I got the object information, I'm actually getting an area around the circle with some extra white space added, so I can just put one on top of the other and the previous one just gets erased by the white space around it. But that's the easiest way to get smooth motion. What we also see is now the movement is actually a lot slower because the put command is really fast, but now it has to wait for the vertical blank for every execution. Of course, you can make it a bit faster by making your steps a bit bigger. And if you don't make them too big, like step 3 in this case, you see, I had to remove the circle. I said that I would do that. Well, let's just wait until it's gone. But now you can see that it's moving a bit faster, but it still looks very, very smooth. It's now moving 3 pixels at a time. And if you have very sensitive eyes, if your eyes are sensitive for motion blur, then you might see some blur. I mean, I see some motion blur now, but not everybody might see it. But you can see that this is a really, really nice way to get the animation running really, really smooth. Just using a put command with some white space around it and waiting for a vertical blank. So that's something we can use. Now I want to explore how we can exploit this. But first of all, I'm curious, and I'm going to load this one, because these commands actually run into the limits quite fast. Because putting this small circle on screen is easy done within the vertical blank. But if I want to move large objects on screen, yeah, if there's a lot of large objects but they are repetitive, you can actually cheat. And that's what I did in this program. In this program, I am basically going to create an array to store my screens, to store 20 screens. And I've put my put mode at 7 in this case. I'm using a variable, it's not really necessary. Yeah, I'm going to draw a ball and draw a background canvas. And what I'm then going to do is sort of draw the animation first, or not draw, but use standard put commands. But the objects are actually quite big, so the put command gets really slow. And I'm putting 6 balls, so ball number 1. And every ball will follow the trajectory of a circle by using the sinq and cosq commands. And I will start at i at 0, and I will continue until 60, so until it's on 60 degrees. And I will do it in steps of 3 degrees, so we will have 20 steps. And on every screen, I will put 6 balls, and every ball will be 60 degrees on the circle shifted compared to the previous one. And I am using the put command, so you would expect that the put command be quite big, but because the objects are quite have become so big now, and it's 6 of them, it's actually too slow to get a decent animation. And I'm doing this drawing and capturing, so every time I'm getting a loop screen, I'm doing the capturing on screen, so you can see the difference between actually using the put commands and the sput canvas in the background. But then I'm starting my cheat, which is basically I'm going to loop the screens by using the sput command and putting one screen after the other, creating the illusion of objects moving on the screen, but I'm just shifting screens in between. So let's see how that looks. As you can see, everything was drawn there, and you can see, yeah, with big objects, putting 6 big objects on screen just waits really, really, it takes very, very long time. But you can also see that actually, once they have been drawn and I'm just putting one screen after another using the sput command, the animation actually looks quite smooth. It's not as smooth as the putting of the circle you saw before, because actually the ST shifter is not fast enough to put a whole screen within one vertical blank. So I think even if I put a V-sync, it will not get a lot smoother. But there were some demos, like the one with the crystal balls animation. People who owned an ST probably know that one. That one was also storing like 16 screens in memory and just looping one after the other. But because the sput command is not fast enough to actually, the shift is not fast enough to put a whole screen within one vertical blank, they actually use a different method to switch between screens. And that method I will not go into right now, but I might do in a future video. But it's kind of cool that you can sort of cheat into creating the illusion of animation. Because of course now I'm using very simple drawings, but you can use like pretty complex screens to, this is the same one, but I'm using the formula for a spirograph. And yeah, it also looks kind of cool. But I also want to see, like, okay, how far can I go with the normal get and put command? So I sort of created some code to combine sort of the concepts and to see how far I can go still within one vertical blank. And of course, I'm doing everything directly drawing on screen. So this everything you will see here is directly drawn on screen. I'm not using any fancy screen swapping routines or anything. And I'm also not using any fancy routines that write directly in memory. So it's all the standard basic commands that have to go through the interpreter and to the variables of get and put and sput. But I just wanted to show like how well it works. So I'm just going to create a logo with some, like it's a box with some text in it. I'm going to create some text, which basically puts some text on the top of the screen. And then I'm going to get it, and as you can see, it's the full width of the screen, and the height is 16 pixels, which is also about the maximum you can get, you can put on the screen with the put command within one vertical blank. If you make the text any bigger, it will already not work anymore. Yeah, and I'm going to just draw sort of a background canvas with some text in it. And then I'm going to just, on the canvas, I'm firstly going to move the text on the bottom of the screen, then I'm going to move the logo around a bit, and the logo will use like the sinq and cosq commands. And then I'm going to combine them both. So basically I'm doing a vsync, then putting the logo, then I have to wait for another vertical blank and then put the text, because I cannot do these both put commands within one vertical blank. The objects are just too big for it. And yeah, but basically this, pardon, this is the same as just moving the text. And when I've done the combo, I'm going to set some arrays and values doing the bounce routine, the line bounce routine, where I incorporated the line bounce routine and the putting of the logo into one loop. So you have to sort of make sure that the numbers for both of them match. So I'm having the x if then commands for the bounce routine. And I'm also looking at if my putting of the text gets below -720, it should make it 720. And it will use that x coordinate to put the text in a constant loop. And after the calculations, I'm doing a vertical blank and then putting the lines. And then it will loop. And at the top again, it will do a vertical blank, then put the logo, put the text. So it will do wait for a vertical blank, put the text, and then do some calculations, then wait for a vertical blank, and then put the lines on screen. Because also the line routine and the text within one vertical blank is already not possible, because my text objects are really, really the limit of what you can do with the put command within one vertical blank. There's no room for anything else. But still, it's nice to see what you can do. And you saw everything being drawn on screen. And you can see the background, which says this is my sad attempt of making a screen with some movement on it. And as you can see, yeah, the text, it still looks, because it can do it just within one vertical blank, it still looks really, really smooth. But this is really the maximum you can do with the put command. So for smooth scrollers, you need something else, because this is a fake scroll text. But the logo is the same. It can put the logo within one vertical blank, so it can animate it. But you can see it's also quite slow. And now I'm combining the two, which means I made the animation step of the logo twice as big, because actually everything gets twice as slow. And the animation step of the text is actually the same, but you can see that the text is moving slower. And it also looks more juddery, because I'm waiting for a vertical blank, then putting the logo, waiting for a vertical blank, then putting the text. So the routines I'm using here, they are already at or even beyond their limits. I think if you want to put some, like you move a logo to some part of the screen after you've put a background, then you can sort of use the put command with a direct drawing. But to make animations better than this, you need some more fancy movements. And I might get to that in future videos, I'm not sure. Because this is actually the second, one of the last videos of series 2 that I'm recording. Because this is basically the last thing I can tell you about the basic commands in BASIC. And I think the videos of series 1 and 2 combined should give you enough knowledge to step into the world of the more fancy commands for putting graphics on screen, which I might do in a series 3 sometime in the future. I don't know exactly when, because there's some stuff on there that I have to sort of figure out myself how it worked again. But I think it's really cool that you can do this much already by using really, really standard interpreted commands from GFR BASIC. Nothing really fancy, no really strange routines, just straight up BASIC commands. And that just shows that it's actually quite a strong BASIC interpreter, the best there is on the Atari ST, maybe the best in BASIC interpreter there ever was. But for now, this video has come to an end. So we looked at the getput with some code loops to get some animations going. There are methods that provide much higher performance. And as said, there's some I have to get into getting up to speed with myself. I just can't remember most of it, so I have to figure it out again. But that's something to look out for that I might do in future videos. For now, I would like to thank you for watching, and I really hope to see you next time.